I'll be happy to, it's my pleasure to do the communion ceremony with you. And by the way, my friend Steve is over here. He will be taking a video for my ailing mom, you know, 91 years old. And I hope you don't mind. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, amen. The grace and peace of God, our Father, and the Lord Jesus Christ be with you. Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare to receive Jesus Christ in the Eucharist. You are sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. Lord, have
mercy. You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated in the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that no tempest may disturb us, for you have set us fast on the rock of our apostles Peter, confession of faith. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the first letter of St. Peter. Beloved, I exhort the presbyters among you, as a fellow presbyter and witness to the sufferings of Christ, and one who has a share in the glory to be revealed. Tend the flock of God in your midst, overseeing not by constraint, but willingly, as God would have it, not for shameful profit, but eagerly. Do not lord it over those assigned to you, but be examples of the flock. And when the chief shepherd is revealed, you will receive the unfading crown of glory. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. In verdant pastures he gives me repose. Beside restful waters he leads me. He refreshes my soul. Even though I walk in the dark valley, I fear no evil, for you are at my side, with your rod and your staff that give me courage. The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want. You spread the table before me in the sight of my foes. You anoint my head with oil, my cup overflows. The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want. Only goodness and kindness follow me all the days of my life, and I shall dwell in the house of the Lord for years to come.
The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want.
When Jesus went into the region of Caesarea Philippi, he asked his disciples, Who do people say that the Son of Man is? They replied, some say John the Baptist, others Elijah, still others Jeremiah or one of the prophets. He said to them, but who do you say that I am? Simon Peter said and replied, you are the Christ, the Son of the living God. Jesus said to him and replied, blessed are you, Simon, son of Jonah. For flesh and blood has not revealed this to you, but my heavenly Father. And so I say to you, you are Peter. And upon this rock I will build my church. And the gates of the netherworld shall not prevail against it. I will give you the keys to the kingdom of heaven. Whatever you bind on earth shall be bound in heaven. And whatever you loose on earth shall be loosed in heaven. The gospel of the Lord.
Morning again. You know, when we were in grade school, if your teacher asks you what is 1 plus 1, of course, well, most of us will say it's 2. But, for example, if your teacher told you that 1 plus 1 is really 3, then you might think that your teacher might be daydreaming, because it's not really 3, it's 2. But when your principal told you that 1 plus 1 is 3, you might be thinking that there's something wrong with your mind. That's what's happening in our gospel today. The apostle is kind of confused. When Jesus asked the apostles, who is the Son of Man? And they say, it might be Jeremiah, John the Baptist, or Elijah. If the apostles who were with Jesus day and night, and they could not even answer Jesus some of the questions, how much more we are. The priests and pastors, they go to seminary for many, many years just to study Christology. What is Christology? Christology is the study of the person of Jesus and his work. So maybe, isn't it for us to learn a little bit of who is Jesus? Most of the time, we hear that to be a Christian, we have to be born again. What is to be born again? In a simple way, is to repent or ask for forgiveness, be baptized, love God, love your neighbor, and love yourself. That simple is that. But how are you going to do that? That's why those priests and pastors studying even after ordination. What is Christology? This coming, in about a couple of weeks, actually March 5th, there's a 4CU retreat that's coming in Carmelite Retreat Center. 4CU is for us to make us more closer to Christ. And then April 25th, there's another one's coming for women. In this retreat, you will feel love, joy, and being closer to Christ. So please consider to join the retreat. You can come to me after the Mass or after the worship, and or Rita can help you. As Jesus said in Matthew 11:25, come to me and I will give you rest.
Lord, you give us all things. Hear us now as we come to you in prayer. Lord, give us your blessings, and we ask you to hear our prayer of he himself expires to us. God, the belonging, help us to free our thoughts to others, especially for your mercy and love. We pray to you, Lord. For Francis of Rome, Daniel our bishop, all the churches and ministers, and all the people, they have been called, for the people of our local community, that they may live in peace and harmony according to God's will, we pray to the Lord. To all the Spirit, that we may be true to the teaching of Jesus, we pray to the Lord. For those who are sick and suffering, that they may put their trust in the Lord, and all upon him, seeking healing and peace in their lives,
we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Who have come to eternal life, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for your need and gathered for today, you may speak now or release them silently to ever-present Father. Almighty God, you have heard our prayers and our needs. We ask that we grant them through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, in one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Please come. Let us pray the prayer of Jesus Christ.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
This is the Lamb of God, who take away the sins of the world. Happy are those who are called to the supper of God.
When I say the word, Lord, I shall be healed.
who are at our celebration of the feast day of the Blessed Apostle Peter, have nourished us by communion in the body and blood of Christ. God, we pray that this redeeming exchange may be for us as a sacrament of unity and peace through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
May the Almighty and merciful God bless us and protect us. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Go in peace.
Thanks be to God.
In Christ. Thanks be to God. Let us pray the Hail Mary. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee.
Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy
Mary, Mother of God,
pray for us sinners,
now and at the hour.
Today, let's sing, especially for Tim's friend, Linda, who's in the hospital, and also for our Pope, the successor of Peter in our present day.
And our manager, Mother Kay.
Make me a channel of your peace. Where there is hatred, let me bring your love. Where there is injury, your pardon, Lord.
Yo comiendo.